told or given assurance that we're going to enjoy some 2 months, you know, off it. What do we need to do as a people for us to get government to at least listen to these people who are telling us that the taxation and the levies on these products is what is killing us and that they should do something about it? What will it take?
We've talked about it.
What? No, maybe it hasn't sung it.
When we keep talking about it, if radio is talking about it, social media is talking about it, and you are telling me that Dr. Matthew Poku-Prempeh, the energy minister, doesn't know, the finance minister, they all know. It is not about how long we are going to say them.
The question is, what will it take for us to get what we are asking for? What will it take?
It will take government.
No, do we need to demonstrate?
No, demonstration is not achieving anything in Ghana now. For me, no. We just have to keep telling them. And we are, you see now today, what I am doing is, I am appealing to the conscience of the president that, Mr. President, if somebody is earning 800 cedis and fuel has been increased just this year in 10 months or 9 months, 2 weeks, by 9 cedis, Mr. President, that person is suffering. And remember that it's not just fuel. The cost of living keeps going up. We understand that there is COVID. That is why me, I will not come and sit here and say that, Mr. President, the COVID tax that you put on petrol, remove it. No. Let it be there.
But you want the SPT to go?
I want the SPT, which is the conditions that necessitated it, is no more there. Remove that. Just that.
0322083596. Listen, give us a call. What do you make of these increase in petroleum products? How is it going to hit you? If you're a teacher, if you're a nurse,